It's that time again, as Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord's modding scene is ramping up in a massive way. And of course it is my job to round up some of the best and most insane mods coming to the game within the next few months. Now, we have so many awesome modifications so far that you can actually go and check out and play now, or go and watch my previous roundup videos where I talk about some other cool mods coming. But without further ado, this is 5 insane mods coming to Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. Mountain Blade Shokuo. The year is 1568. In the far aftermath of the disastrous Onin War and the infighting of feuding clans across Japan, turmoil is rife and has turned lands into bountiful prey for all rungs of society, from the likes of the Usugi Kenshin right down to the masses. From abroad the distant seas, the Portuguese Naban, barbarians from the west have brought the spread of Christianity and new technologies from afar. You have been thrown into Sengoku Jidai, the Warring States era of Japan. In your hands lies the power to craft your own destiny. Whether you take up a sword in hand, it's up to you to carve your own path in Japan's history and make a name for yourself, be that through cunning or brute force. That is just but an excerpt taken from the Shokuo Mod DB page for the project that is coming to Bannerlord. This, as you may have worked out, is the older brother of the famous Gekukuju mod for Mountain Blade Warband, and it's back, bigger than ever. The development team behind some of these Bannerlord mods are sometimes bigger than many full game studios now, and this is no different. With over 70 developers working on Shokuo, progress is thick and fast. The mod is going to include many different arms and armors from Japan that the player can choose and customize with in many different ways, such as the katana, the naginata, the nodachi, and many, many more. Fighting with the right weapon for your playstyle will be just as important as it is in the native campaign, but the actual fighting in this mod is going to be somewhat special. You see, with the vast amounts of new abilities that the modding tools gives developers, you can expect new and custom animations and even stances throughout the mod in order to fit the period and fighting styles of the time. This has a massive impact on what attack you will be choosing with what weapons you will be using. To make a certain attack, you're going to have to be in the right stance for said attack in order to carry it through, and I think this is an awesome way of doing it. It gives a whole new dynamic to the already incredible Mountain Blade combat. You, as a player, are going to have to make sure you know which stances are necessary and all their advantages and weaknesses throughout your battles. In addition, they have created custom parry animations that glide your blade off the enemies and flows into an attack of your own, much like that you would expect and you've seen in many Japanese-inspired games and movies in the past. All in all, I think this mod is a massive one to watch out for. It's going to create a whole new gameplay style, not just in troop overhauls, but the combat, and differing to the ways that you would expect a normal Mountain Blade campaign to play out. A World of Ice and Fire, the Known World. Everyone knows the World of Ice and Fire mod for Warband. It was, without a doubt, one of the biggest single-player mods the game ever had. With over 500,000 unique downloads, it took players into the world of Game of Thrones, fighting battles, winning wars, slaying beasts, and all in all, conquering Westeros. And it is back with A World of Ice and Fire, the Known World. Much of it is as you would expect. Many of the parts from the Warband mod will be making a return, and I assume this will be a big advantage in development with assets that are already made, yet with the jump in quality from Warband to Bannerlord, I don't doubt there is still a lot to do. But you can expect that same type of polish that we got in the Warband modification. You can see from a developer blog uploaded to the channel, the difference in fidelity between Warband and Bannerlord versions is immense. It looks gorgeous. The wear and tear on the shield, the specs in the armor. Many people have made the statement that Bannerlord wasn't all that graphically impressive, but this tells a different story. Especially with hundreds of soldiers on the battlefield at the same time, with all such detailed weaponry and armor, it will truly be another sight to see. You can recreate all your favorite battles from Game of Thrones, whether it is the books or the TV shows or even some stories that we've heard of from the past. But currently we have very little information so far, but do expect something similar to what came before. All the factions and clans that you would expect from Westeros, a whole new map with custom scenes and cities, custom quests and NPCs that you can interact with, and new options when interacting with them, especially in cities and towns. I think for me at least, the main lookout for this mod is the arms and armor. It's so important to get the details right, as immersing someone in a fantasy world is hard enough, so giving the player an incredible visual experience will help out to no end. But hey, we saw what they could do with the Warband version, as I mentioned, so who says they can't do it again with A World of Ice and Fire, the Known World. North and South. Okay, out of all the mods I'm going to be showcasing in this video, this is perhaps the least fleshed out and detailed when it comes to actual information that we know so far, and there's kind of a reason for this. It's just been announced. In the last month or so, the page appeared on ModDB speaking of the current development on North and South, an American Civil War mod for Mountain Blade 2, Bannerlord. Many of you may have heard this mod title before because this was once again a Warband version, and much like the Warband version of the mod, it will be multiplayer only. I'm so happy about that because it means the team's full focus will be on creating a new, shinier version of what we got in the previous game. And if it even has a fraction of the success of Warband's modification, it will be brilliant. For anyone that doesn't know, North and South, the first Manassas, was one of the most successful and downloaded mods from Mountain Blade Warband full stop, even if it was only multiplayer. It took this multiplayer-only expansion and gave the players the ability to head into the American Civil War to fight for glory. The regiments from the Napoleonic Wars DLCs headed over to create regiments based on historical groups of the Civil War this time, who fought in line battles, or at least the Civil War version, using few more tactics, terrains, and trenches to win the day instead of the old Napoleonic Wars way of just hoping you don't get shot while standing out in the open. But as I said, there is almost nothing on this mod so far, so as I expect, it has only just begun full development, much like some of the others, but expect incredible upgrades in visual fidelity. The sound design is so important. If you go and look at a game like War of Rights, which was actually based on the North and South mod for Mountain Blade Warband, the sound design really makes that game and immerses the player in it. I can't wait to be fixing bayonets again on the battlefield with my regiment, getting ready to charge into a house that is being held by Confederate soldiers. Hopefully, that isn't too far away. Co-op mod. Where have I heard about this mod before? Oh yeah, I made a dedicated video on it. You should probably go and check it out. It's a pretty good video. As you may have worked out, I love rounding up mods, but the big ones that I think are absolutely game-changing, I will make a full dedicated video to them. And that was no different with the co-op mod for Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. Yes, you heard me. Co-op play is coming to the game, and it's already being shown off, making me incredibly jealous. Being able to join your friend's game, joining parties together against other lords to create alliances, or even becoming enemies and going off on your own, creating your own kingdom and going to war with your fellow player. You'll still be able to interact with NPCs as usual and go about your regular world conquering if that's more your thing, but the possibilities to marry, having relationships and forming bonds with other players will be in the mod. So it all sounds pretty perfect, right? Well, it gets even better. Furthermore, the possibilities are endless, with the announcement of the co-op mod itself supporting other mods within itself. Being able to have troop overhauls and new maps to play cooperatively with friends. I mean, imagine this, forming your own fellowship and traveling Middle-earth with your mates, raising an army and taking on the might of Mordor together. And finally, The Witcher, Northern Wars. As someone who has only just got round to playing Witcher 3, yes, I know, it has been in my library for years, but I've never actually hopped on and realised what a beauty of a game it actually is. But this mod announcement excited me more than most. Much like the North and South page, there's very little really to dive in about the depth of this mod, but as you'd expect, it's set in the world of the books, games, and now TV show, attempting to recreate many of the battles we often hear about but rarely actually take part in. As much of the time, we're actually seeing the story through the eyes of the Witcher. Many world events that we hear about pass us by and we only actually know about them through stories and songs, but now, with the Witcher Northern Wars mod for Bannerlord, we're going to be placed in the shoes of a soldier, fighting against the Nilfgaardians, or maybe even for them, finding your place in the world through good and evil, and perhaps there'll be some familiar faces that we see along the way. Currently, we have screenshots of only the armor that has been created, but from the looks of it, even these models are still very early in development. But give it a bit of slack. The mod is being made by one person. A lone developer has taken on the task that this is one of the main reasons that I wanted to feature the mod in this video. So many of these teams have tens, if not hundreds of people chipping in for the mod, but this one hero is taking it upon himself to create the world of The Witcher in Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord alone. But which of these mods excite you the most? Are you wanting any of these developers to come on my channel for an interview so you can ask your own questions? Make sure you leave a comment down below and I will get on that as soon as possible. But please leave a like on the video if you enjoyed it. It helps more than you would ever know. But until then, I will see you in the next one.